our drug laws have failed and what we can do about it. Good morning, Judge. Thanks for joining us.
Ted, it's nice to be with you.
Clearly, there's some momentum here. You have the ad airing this week, although a couple television stations chose not to air it. You have the governor talking about there should be a debate on legalizing marijuana. Do you think this is unstoppable at this point?
There's no question, Ted, that it's going to happen eventually. It's just a question of when. But when people allow themselves to focus on reality, on what's happening, they will agree to regulate, control, and tax marijuana, and it's going to happen.
And you should believe, the law should be left up to the states, and the federal government shouldn't be involved.
You know, we have a nation that has 50 crucibles of democracy. Let's find out what works the best, just like we did when we repealed alcohol prohibition. We did not say that California will now sell alcohol. It left it up to the states. That's the best way to do it. That's what our country was founded on, sure.
Tell me why violence and crime gets reduced if drugs are legalized, in particular marijuana.
Al Capone. There was enormous amount of violence involved in the distribution of alcohol back in alcohol prohibition. It went away to the degree that homicides went down by 40% the first year after we repealed alcohol prohibition. The same thing is going to happen when we repeal drug prohibition. It's the same thing.
Of course, the argument against it is if you make marijuana legal, more people will use it, and the consequences of such use, car accidents and the like, will increase.
Today, there's more marijuana available. We couldn't make it more available if we tried. In fact, it's the largest cash crop in the state of California today. It's unregulated. It's untaxed. It's easier for our young people to get marijuana than it is a six-pack of beer. Why? Because the marijuana dealers don't ask for ID, and of course, they want people to use it. So if you look at Holland, which is a really good example, they have marijuana available in coffee shops, etc., and they have only half the marijuana consumption in Holland as we do here in our country, both for adults and for teenagers. And the Minister of Health told us why. You know what he said? He said, we have succeeded in making pot boring. Now, of course, we glamorize it because it's illegal, and we also have a profit motive to get our children involved with it. It isn't working. It's got to change.
But is there an argument in that culturally we're different from Holland and that we are consumers, and if this something is legal, we'll just consume more of it?
Well, then that's obvious. If you're going to decrease the price, which you have to do to get the illegal dealers out of business, and it's no longer illegal, are people going to increase their usage? Yes, they will. And in a lot of ways, maybe they'll use marijuana instead of alcohol or a methamphetamine, which brings on a different
issue. And isn't that a problem? People use more marijuana?
Well, maybe, but they're going to use it anyway. And in fact, ask our kids, because I do, it's easier for them to get marijuana than it is alcohol, and it's easier for adults as well. So let's recognize that fact. Also, we don't have the impurities problem that we used to with alcohol, now we don't. So all of these things factor in. Plus, of course, there is the issue of money. I wouldn't do it just because the state would get more revenue, but it's certainly a nice enticement on its side.
And there are doctors who simply say marijuana is bad for you, and we shouldn't legalize something that's bad
Ted,
for you.
Cigarettes are bad for you. Do you want to make them illegal? Then you just make these nicotine-addicted people criminals. You know, it's there. It's here to stay. Let's regulate it, control it, and then focus on what works. Drug treatment does work. Honest education does work, and also getting that profit motive away from some really unsavory people also works.
But cigarettes are not a mind-altering substance.
Well, they are. They are mind-altering.
Not in the extreme,
addicting
in the same way. Okay.
They're as addicting as cocaine. 60%, according to the head of the drug czar, 60% of the Mexican cartel profits come from the sale of marijuana. Most street gangs, juvenile gangs, profit by selling marijuana. Let's do away with that. Let's stop funding these bad guys, too. There's lots and lots of stuff to talk about. We need to address it. AB 390, which I know you're aware of, Assemblyman Tom Amiano out of San Francisco, has a bill pending.
We're going to keep
track
of
marijuana that. Like Definitely. Alcohol. That's where we should
go. Retired Orange County Judge Jim Gray, the book is Why Our Drug Laws Have Failed and What We Can Do About It. Thank you for joining us, Judge.
It's a pleasure.